So we're now ready. We have a jazz orchestra here, all assembled, and we have two pieces that are rarely played, even though they are written by the most famous big band composer in the history of jazz, which is, or was, Duke Ellington. Duke Ellington. Ellington has so many pieces, we're still discovering what he wrote. And to listen to jazz stations like K-Jazz, they'll play a lot of Ellington, but you'll rarely hear these pieces played. So I want to try to, uncover some of this, especially because it was a result of a tour that he made in 1963. He goes through parts of Asia, representing the United States for a State Department tour. They called them Goodwill Ambassadors. And the idea was that jazz is a way to show that America is a place of kind of democracy, and we welcome all kinds, and we have this kind of music that shows that people of different backgrounds can come together and come together in unity. So Ellington was sent out, and he went to different parts of, we would say, the Near East or so-called Middle East. He went as far as India. He didn't make it actually to China or Japan. So it's a bit of a misnomer, but they call this work the Far East Suite. It should be the Near East Suite, but it is what it is. We know what we have. So the first piece is called Mount Harissa. It was in Beirut, so it's in Lebanon at this time. The second piece is called Blue Pepper, Far East of the Blues is the subtitle. Blue Pepper, Far East of the Blues. So we have two pieces from the Far East Suite, and of course we have our guest artist here, the wonderful Buman.
But I'm sure Duke Ellington didn't thought about going to be peepop, so I'm the Far East.
Yeah, like I said, jazz, right? You can do it, yeah. Okay, Mount Harissa, thank you.